Alright, in this video we are going to see how to convert this design into the HTML and CSS. Now this screen what you are seeing is just a desktop view, a desktop design, and in this video we are going to see how to create this same screen for mobile version and for tablet version. The design would be different as we do in all the videos. So there is going to be the three version of this design. Now in case if you want to follow with me, I will leave the source code and the images so that you can follow with me. And if you want to learn how to create this kind of wireframe, I have a separate tutorial for this. Now you can see this is a section which we are creating right now. This whole section, this whole page, it's a landing page. This is created with the help of Figma. If you want to learn, you can visit the link. I'll leave the link in the description, and here you can get all the assets so that you can follow along. And this is just an image, and if you wish to convert the same image into the working website, I have a separate tutorial for that. So this is the perfect landing page which you have created with the help of WordPress. In the WordPress I have used the plugin called WP Bakery. So just by dragging and dropping, the same website is replicated over here and it is live. This is the image, and this is not the image, this is the actual website. Fine, now we are getting deeper into it. So we are extracting the individual part, and we are solving it with the help of HTML and CSS. Fine, now let's get started. Just to give you an overview, we have a section, and inside section we have a container so that we can give some left and right margin. Inside the container we have a heading, first heading, second heading and paragraph, and then we have a row. Inside the row we have first column, and inside the row we have second column. And inside the first row we have these text, paragraph, heading and small heading, and inside the second column we have image. Fine, now let's work on the HTML. So section, inside the section we have container. Inside container we have a row. So okay, we'll first create this. Inside the row we have column. This is first column and this is second column. Inside the first column we have paragraph, lorem of 20 words, and then we have heading, let's say h6, make this as have any name, let me type my name, and then we have task title again, so let it be h5, and then let the h6 be. Fine, now let's add the image over here. IMG tag inside IMG folder. Let's open the folder. Inside IMG folder we have x4.jpg. So now we will add h3, it will be testimonial. Then we will have h4, which is what our client says, and after that we have a paragraph, let's say lorem of 20 words again. So if I show you the actual HTML, this is how it looks. So let me open it for you. On the desktop we have this kind and index. So this is the HTML. For some reason the image is not showing up, let me see why. MGSRC, inside image folder I have z4. If I refresh, we'll see the image. Fine, now let's start working on the CSS. So on the head tag you can see this is the font family Roboto, and this is the font awesome icon. We don't need this, and we have external style sheet, and this is what we have linked. For all element I have given the font family Roboto, and I have removed the margin and padding which is given default by the browser. Once this is done, what we can do is we need to create section. Inside the section we have container. Inside the container we have h4, actually it's h3. Then we have h4, then we have paragraph, and inside the container we have row also, and inside the row we have first column, and inside the first column we have paragraph, inside the first column we have H5, and inside the first column we have H6. Now let's work on the second column. We have image, that's it. So I would recommend you to write this kind of hierarchy so that to avoid CSS overriding issue. So at this particular we just have one section, so there is very less chance of having override issue. But on the actual web page I have shown you there were almost 6 to 10 section, so there could be a chance of having multiple CSS classes with same name. So to avoid this kind of override issue, we have added the hierarchy. Fine. Now let's add margin, top and bottom for the section. Margin, top and bottom 50 pixel, left and right 0, and whatever is there inside I want the text align to be center. And now container, I want the margin, top and bottom. Top and bottom is all right, 0, left and right 50 pixel. So the one thing I can do is we can eliminate the margin from the section and we'll add it to the container. Refresh it, nothing is going to change. Then let's work on these three section first. So let's copy the, I think we have not copied the, we have copied the, what do we call, color red. Now let's cube the design, inspect this and take this out, copy this, and let's have the color and text or text transform uppercase and letter spacing 10 pixel, and font size let's say 5 pixel, very small. Cool. Even though you can add some more, make it even bigger, that's all right. Now copy the whole thing and paste it for the H3. Now let's work on the H4. Select the H4 and give the font size of 35 pixel and you can make font weight of 100 500. Now margin bottom of 15 pixel and then text transform capitalize. And now let me see, everything seems all right. Just copy this and paste it for the H4. Now let's check. Actually you can see there is some space on the left and right. In that case what we can do is we can make a div with class para holder, and inside that we can place the paragraph. So let me make this camel case. So we have para holder before this, now we can give width to the para holder. Let me try. So width of 70%, even more actually you can see there is some problem. Actually you have to choose a para holder width of 70%, make it even smaller. And let's give TextAlign Center. TextAlign Center won't work here. We have to give TextAlign to the, or you can give margin 0 and auto, so that it aligns at the center. And color gray, margin bottom, let's say 50 pixel. Let's place this. This is for para. If this is the saw, this is the another trick for center and center align. Almost there, you can see. Just have to increase the font size and line width. Let's increase the font size for the paragraph and the line width, line height. Line height 12 pixel. Font size 18 pixel. Cool. This is for the paragraph. Now let's work on the grid section. We want these two to be side by side. So for that, get the container, which is row display flex, and let the width be 50% each. Refresh this. So 50-50. Now I want, okay, I don't need, with anything we don't need spaces. So if you want space, what you can do is, let's add the margin top and bottom 0, left and right 50 pixel on both sides. And for the image, let the height and width be 100%. That means it will obey what the container has. The container has the width. So cool, now you can see almost fitted. For the first column, I think it's wise to give the first column an ID, BG red. Now choose the first column and give background color red, and the color red is going to be this one. And now if you see, we have to place it properly at the right place. So the for the column, we have column, first column over here. So just place it properly. We should not leave space. That means in this column we have a ID. So if I refresh, and I think we need to keep the color white, and I want this to be at the center. For that, what we can do is display flex, align item, center, justify content, center, and I want this to be one below the other. So flex direction column, and let's add padding, or let's say your padding is right, top bottom 0, left and right 50 pixel each. I don't want this to get shrinked. So what we can do is, let's remove the padding and give the padding to the paragraph. Now let's design this as per our need. Font size 20 pixel, margin bottom 20 pixel. Cool. Place this. Now the web designer text is okay, but we want to increase the font size, let's say 15 pixel. This is 20 pixel and this is 16 pixel. Refresh it. I think it's too big. Let us make it 14 pixel. Cool. So we have completed this design. Now let's work on the mobile view. So as we always do, let's target the breakpoint. That breakpoint is simply we are going to target a particular screen sizes. So if you see, these are the tools. This is for tablet and this is for desktop. You might be wondering, we just created the design for desktop, why we are adding the breakpoint for desktop. So there is the concept called mobile first, which is introduced by Bootstrap. So always we should design for the mobile first. So that means let's get into the mobile view. Let's stick this. So always we should design for the mobile view. So for the mobile view, let's design it. Let the para holder, let me make this 100%. Copy this and search here. We have to make this as 100% for mobile, but for desktop we want to make it as 60%. So whatever you write inside the breakpoint, or you can say media query, it will just override what is actually there. So actually if you see, we have more property, like about 5 properties there, but we are just adding one property on the breakpoint. That means these 5 property will be applied along with it, will be overridden. So if I refresh and check, and now what we can do is, let's make the row, let me remove the margin, so select this, and I want to remove the margin for the mobile, and I want to add it for the desktop. Now you can see I'm just adding the margin and removing the grid. Now let me just zoom in a bit. Now I want this section to be at the first one below the other. Now if you remember, we have given the width to the column. Let me make the width, let me make the column width as 100%. Copy this and give the width of the column as 100%, but it should be 50 for mobile, sorry desktop, 50 for desktop. And get the row and give the flex direction column, select all and have the flex direction column. Refresh this. Cool. Now the trick part is, we want this to be at the top, so let's select the BG thread which is already there, and let me make the order 2. Now let's refresh and check. So order 2 is working fine, but for desktop it should be order 1, not this but the whole. But for desktop it should be order 1. So actually what you should do is, you should give two different ID. This is BG red, and let me give this ID image holder. So let's copy this and give it image holder. Let me copy all the thing. So now this is going to be for the mobile, the image is going to be at the top. That means one for image and two for the background color. In contrast, for the desktop we want the text content to be at the first, and we want the text content to be at the first, and we want the image to be at the second. So one and two order. Refresh this. Great. Now what we can do is, we can give min height, minimum height, let's say 300 pixel, for the mobile screen 300 pixel. Refresh this. So this is perfect for mobile screen. Now let's check the desktop view. Refresh this. The one thing is, we have to make this flex direction column. We have missed that. So you have to get the row. We'll check where is zero. Actually, row is here, and we have to remove the flex direction. Not, we don't have to remove. We have to override with row. Row is for the default. And now, cool. The desktop version is done, and the mobile version is also done. Both are perfect. Now, in between the breakpoint 768 and 992, there is tablet version. So let's get into the 800 bit width. So this is 800, and if it is from 800 to 992, this is tablet. For tablet, you this much big image won't work great. In that case, what we do is we just copy the same thing and paste it for the desktop. So both of them is going to be same. If you want to change a little bit, so what you can do is you can change the order. So for tablet, image will be on the left side. On the desktop, image will be on the right side. So this is the minimum thing that we can give. So now you can see this is for mobile screen, and this is for the tablet, and this is for the desktop.